Hello guys, so this is list 8 of our vocab T10 series. The theme I'm going to take up today is food, and the method used is mnemonics. The first word is comestible. Comestible means eatable, edible. It's an adjective. However, if you add an S to the word comestibles, it becomes a noun. So when I use the word comestibles, I'm referring to eatables. Some of you might have heard this announcement on metros, on Delhi Metro, maybe Mumbai Metro. Comestibles are not allowed on the Delhi Metro. So eatables are not allowed. Now, memory tip, how to memorize this word, how to retain it for long. If you look at this word, if you try to break it from here, comestibles. What we see is a mess, table. Those of you who have lived in hostels can relate. Pathetic comestibles on mess table. Pathetic comestibles on mess table. So this is how you can memorize this word. And because mess has pathetic comestibles to offer, we seek some tasty food outside. For tasty, a common word is palatable, delicious, delectable, tasty. Palate is the roof of your mouth. So the upper part of your mouth that you can touch your tongue on, that part is called palate. So if a food is palatable, it is acceptable to the palate, to your palate, right? How do I memorize this word now? Palatable. So you visit an expensive restaurant and you know that the food there is tasty, you are so excited, you're gung-ho. What you do is you run and you occupy the pehla table because the food is palatable. So this is how you can memorize, retain this word for long. The more ridiculous the link, the more interesting the link, easier it is for us to retain the word. So I occupied pehla table because the food was palatable. Synonyms for tasty: scrumptious, not to be confused with sumptuous, I've heard many people using this word sumptuous wrongly. Sumptuous does not mean tasty, it means rich, luxurious or costly. In Hindi, the word is shahi, if you understand the word shahi. So sumptuous is rich, luxurious, costly, expensive. So if I say sumptuous food, I'm talking about shahi khana, chappan bhog, which is not necessarily tasty. But yes, usually it is. So scrumptious is tasty, while sumptuous is royal, rich, luxurious. You can relate the two words. Sumptuous food, that is costly, rich, expensive food, chappan bhog, is usually scrumptious. That's how you can retain both the words. Sumptuous food is usually scrumptious. Next word, dainty. It again means tasty, dainty. Dai auntie. So a dai comes to you. She cooks for you. If you live in a PG, so dai auntie cooks dainty food. Dainty food by dai auntie. That's how you can memorize it. Ambrosial. Well, ambrosia is the food offered to gods. Food offered to gods. That is called ambrosia. So, ambrosia, amber, that is skies. Amber se aaya rasoiya to prepare ambrosia. अंबर का रसोईया दैट इज कुक, द कुक ऑफ द स्काईज प्रिपेयर्स अम्ब्रोजियल फूड. अंबर से आया रसोईया टू प्रिपेयर अम्ब्रोजिया. नाउ दिस इज दीज लिंक्स दिस मेमोरी टिप्स आर गोइंग टू हेल्प यू रिटेन दीज वर्ड्स फॉर लॉन्ग हाउएवर रिडिकुलस दे साउंड. इन फैक्ट द मोर रिडिकुलस द बेटर. अंबर से आया रसोईया टू प्रिपेयर अम्ब्रोजिया अम्ब्रोजियल फूड. A slightly different word but related to this word family, luscious. Luscious is sweet and juicy. Rich, appealing, attractive. And it is used for food. It could also be used for someone's physical characteristics. So the word has sexual connotations as well. Luscious fruit. It is often used for fruits. Strawberries and lychees, all these fruits which are juicy and sweet, luscious fruit. But the word can also be used for lips, and that is why you see this picture, this image, luscious lips. Our desi version is hot rasile. So we have a song too, right? So luscious lips. This is how the word is used. Now, to retain this word, luscious sounds like delicious. So simple link. Luscious is equal to delicious. Next, savory. While luscious is sweet and juicy, savory is spicy and tasty. So you should not use this word savory for any food whatsoever. Savory is specifically used for food that is spicy and tasty. The pseudo Chinese food is savory. Noodles, Manchurian and all, savory food, right? Savory. What do we see in savory? How do we retain this word now? What we see here, savory, savian, noodles. In our language, in our tongues, noodles are called savian. So savory, savian. Right. This is how you can retain. Let's talk about the opposite word family, the antonyms. Insipid. Insipid is tasteless. So porridge or khichdi, which is called polenta in English, by the way, khichdi. So insipid food, simply tasteless food. What do we see insipid? You can't even take a sip because it is insipid. That's how you retain this word. So I can't sip this insipid soup. Synonym, bland. I hope some of you are aware of this word already. Bland food, it's tasteless, no spices, no salt. This blend of water and pulses, which is called khichdi. So this blend of water and pulses is bland. This is how you can retain, for those of you who might not be aware of this word already. Another synonym, vapid. Boring, dull, tasteless. Guys, these words are not used only in context of food. They can be used in context of anything that is uninteresting, that is dull, that is boring, that is tasteless, anything. So a vapid TV show is absolutely correct usage of the word. Right. A vapid novel, book, etc. Vapid food. Right. Because you cooked it rapidly, the food is vapid. Khichdi is cooked rapidly, right? So cooked rapid, the food is vapid. This is how you could retain the word. So this is the word family we have discussed today. Palatable, tasty. I occupied pehla table because the food was palatable. Scrumptious. Sumptuous food is usually scrumptious, while sumptuous means royal, costly, rich, shahi. Scrumptuous is tasty. Ambar se aya rasoiya to prepare ambrosia. Ambrosia is the food offered to the gods, and ambrosial means tasty, therefore. Dainty. Dainty food by Dayanti. Dayanti prepares dainty food. Luscious is delicious, rich, juicy, sweet. Savory, spicy. Savia, savory. I can't take a sip because the food is insipid, bland. The blend of water and pulses, khichdi, is bland, vapid, cooked rapidly. The food is vapid. And the generic word for food, comestibles, eatables. So pathetic comestibles on the mess table. Hope you enjoyed it. Keep watching, keep sharing, keep liking. Prepare for the non-CAT and OMATs. Prepare for GRE, prepare for GMAT. Whichever exam you're writing, do prepare for them thoroughly. Vocab is an important component of this preparation. Signing off.